in 1978, when my sister and me were like 7 and 5 years old, and at that moment we'd like to have a brother, and my parents thought of adopting a child, but preferred to have that in a that the child should stay at the family in their own place, their own community, but then like sponsoring, and so that's why they thought of foster parents plan. And they asked for a boy about the same age as we were, so that finally became Guillermo. Guillermo was 5 years old at that time. We would tell everybody we would have a brother in our self-care. And we were really proud of that, so that's nice. And we always had this picture next to a picture of me and my sister. Mm-hmm. And I think last year I realized, oh, where's the picture? And I asked my mom, do you still have this picture in the frame from Guillermo? And she said, yeah, I have it. And I also have all the letters and all the photographs. So that's when I asked her, oh, can you give me the whole file? And so she gave it to me, and I went back with the train to my house and started reading all the letters. And I was really like, wow. So what happened with Guillermo? How will he be now? And how's our brother doing? 20 years ago, since we received his last letter, 1991. So then I contacted the Plan office in Holland and told them about my story, and they really liked it, so they were going to try to help me finding Guillermo. Well, it was going to be very, very difficult to find him, and I was like, I don't like. So I was like going through all the letters and picked up all information, all the names I could find, and the school he went to, and a community he used to live, and put that in one file, and then...
You became a detective.
Yeah, that's it. And then I was really nervous every day. I opened my email. Oh, will there be a message? will I know more? And then there was this relative, and I was like, oh, now we're getting closer. But then maybe he doesn't want us to come over, or maybe there are things that are not nice, or I didn't know, so I was really nervous about it. And then there was this email. Good news, we found him. He's 37 years old, has a wife, 3 children, he's a truck driver, and he owns his truck. I thought it was pretty cool. So then I was really happy, and then I started preparing the trip to El Salvador, because I knew I was coming over.
You came to El Salvador, you met him. Tell me about the meeting. How was it?
I was very nervous. He too, I think. And yeah, that it was a kind of overwhelming. It's just difficult to describe, I think. It's a feeling, and it felt really good.
What did your mom feel? Because she became a sponsor, a foster mom somehow.
Yeah.
When she met Guillermo, how did she feel?
Very emotional, and for her it has been really important to support Guillermo when he was young and growing up. And for my parents, it's an important story. It's also part of their life. It's something they really wanted to do it. And also they hoped they could make a difference. So even if it would be just a little difference. We also realized that, I mean, the story of his life, it hasn't been easy. It's such a hard, a very difficult to understand story, actually. Mm-hmm. And especially when you come from Holland, mm-hmm. Where everything is quite organized, and well, we have it quite good, I think. Well, that's confronting. So I decided I wanted to follow him in his daily life, like how he's living now with his family and with his work, and like with playing football as well. Mm-hmm. But I also wanted to go to the places he grew up, and that place that has a special meaning for him, and also his old school and things like that. I realized I had all his pictures, and he, because he had, during the war, he had to leave his house immediately. They had to leave everything, so he will not. He didn't have any picture of himself, not from his grandmother, nothing. So then I realized, wow, I do have like 24 pictures of him from like 5 years old till 18, and he doesn't have anything. That it also didn't feel fair, you know, like I had a piece of his life, and he didn't know that, so I wanted to give that back. It's really interesting, not only because it's a personal story, but there are so many layers in the story. I mean, it's also about Plan. They he was like a sponsor child in the 70s, 80s. And now his oldest son is a sponsor child again. So it's like a circle which is going on. And I think it's really interesting to see how an organization as Plan is working those days and is working nowadays, and how it helped him in his life. So that was what interested me as well. And then also the political story, a story of which I think never realized that was that big, the story of the war and how it affected him and his family. It has been so beautiful to do it like this, and imagine that, I mean, he has children now, I have children now, they're actually the same age. And I tell my children about El Salvador now, so it's like it started when I was 7, and now my children are 8 and 10 years old, and I can tell them, so I think that's important. And my parents started it, but, you know, I grew up with it, and I'm now continuing it, actually, so I think that's beautiful.